Hi, I'm Dr.Nydile, Consultant Dermatologist at Pelure Skin Clinic, HSR Layout, Bangalore. Hair fall can be very distressing, but it's important to know that not all hair fall is the same. Let's break down the different types of hair fall and the treatments for each type. Androgenetic alopecia. This is the most common type of hair fall which affects both men and women. It's often hereditary and progresses gradually, leading to thinning of the hair or baldness. But not to worry, there are various types of treatment available. There are topical treatments like minoxidil and certain peptide-based hair serums can be used. Oral treatment like fenasteride, oral minoxidil can be taken to regrow the hair and to prevent the baldness. And there are certain procedures that halt the hair thinning and helps in regrowing of the hair. These are like PRP, GFC, hair mesotherapy, low-level light laser therapy. And at last, there is surgical option, that is hair transplant, if there is a complete baldness. Telogen effluvium. Well, this is also the most common type of hair fall that we see in a day-to-day basis. Hair growth occurs in a cycle with several different stages. There is growing phase, transition phase, resting phase, while at the end there is a hair shedding. Generally, 85 to 90% of the hair is in the growing stage. 10 to 15% of the hair is in the resting phase that happens before hair shedding. But in telogen effluvium, this balance is reversed. More than 10% of the hair goes to resting phase. This leads to a lot of hair fall and sudden increase in the hair loss. So what causes this telogen effluvium? The most common cause is stress, like any significant emotional distress or any major surgery or illness can cause significant stress to the body. Then there is hormonal imbalance like postpartum hair loss, menopause, thyroid imbalance. Then there is nutritional deficiency like iron, magnesium, zinc deficiency can cause hair fall. Also, any acute illness like typhoid, dengue can also cause the telogen effluvium. The treatment is very simple, like reducing the stress, improving the diet, or topical medications like hair serums containing peptides. Some nutritional support can reverse this condition. There are also other type of hair fall which can lead to patchy hair loss, like alopecia areata. This is an autoimmune mediated condition where our defense mechanisms start attacking our own hair cells, leading to patchy hair loss. But always consult a dermatologist if you are suffering from this condition because it needs the right medical treatment. Then there is traction alopecia, which happens due to prolonged tension on the hair, especially due to tight hairstyles. Avoiding tight hairstyle is the mainstay of this treatment, so always consult a dermatologist to rule out any other cause of the hair fall. Nutritional deficiency can also lead to hair fall. Deficiency in nutrients like iron, zinc, and certain other minerals can lead to hair fall. The treatment is very simple. Follow a balanced diet and consult a dermatologist if there is severe deficiency to get the appropriate medication. There are other certain causes like fungal infections of the hair, which can also lead to patchy hair fall, which is more common in children. Again, this needs medical attention because proper antifungal therapy is needed to treat the hair fall.